In the last session, we discussed exercise 2.0 up to 5 questions. Now see the next question. What the next question says here, a man walks 10 kilometers and then travels a certain distance by train and then by bus as far as twice by the train. If the whole journey is of 70 kilometers, how far he travels by train? Here, they have given some conditions here. What they given here, a man walks 10 kilometers by walk. That means here, a man, let us suppose the man starts at this point and he walks 10 kilometers and after that what they said here, then travels a certain distance by train. At this point, he travels a certain distance by train. Let us consider, let us suppose this is the distance he traveled by train. Let us consider that one. So here, we don't know how much distance he traveled. Let us consider it as x. And after that, what is the next condition given here? And then by bus. And at this point, he traveled by bus. How much he distance he traveled? And here they have given the condition as far as twice by the train. Twice is nothing but double. So here, how much distance he traveled by train? S. But he traveled at this point bus, which is double. That means let us consider this as x and this as x. That means he traveled 2x. So here, this is the condition given. And they have given after that if the whole journey is 70 kilometers, that means if this total journey is 70 kilometers and they ask here how far he traveled by train. That means you need to calculate this distance. This is the question they have given here. Let us again see the question here. What they said, let us consider the man starts at this point. He walks 10 kilometers by walk and at this point he traveled by train. And he reached at this point and after that in the question they have given that he covered the distance twice that of the train. That means if the distance travelled by the train is x, then what will be the distance travelled by the bus, which is 2x, double of that one. And here they have given the total journey at this point by walk, by train and by the bus. This total journey together he travels 70 kilometers. And in the question they asked to find what is the distance he travelled by train. That means you need to calculate this distance. So here, from this figure, you can clearly observe that if you add this 10 kilometers plus x plus 2x, you have to get here 70 kilometers. So here, that is here, 10 plus x plus 2x is equal to 70. This is the question they have given. Now here, you need to find the distance travelled by the train, which is x. So here, 10 plus, what is the value of 2x plus x, which is 3x? Is equal to 70. If you take 10 to that side, it will become minus 10. You will get 70 minus 10, which is 60. What is the value of x here? 60 by 3, which is 20. So he traveled 20 kilometers by train. If you can see here whether we have done correct or wrong, you can see it here. How much distance he traveled by train, which is 20. But how much distance he has to travel by bus, which is double of that, 20 plus 20, which is 40. Now calculate whether you are getting 70 kilometers or not. So here, 40 plus 20, which is 60, plus 10, which is 70. So here, like this, you need to solve the problem. Now, write this one. So write it here. Let the distance traveled by train is equal to x kilometers. Then the distance traveled by the bus, according to the question, it must be equal to 2x kilometers. And here the distance traveled by walk plus x plus 2x, this total journey must be equal to 70. So here, what you get here, which is 3x plus 10 is equal to 70. If you take 10 to the right hand side, it will become 60. And what is the value of x, which is 60 by 3, which is 20. So write it here, the distance traveled by train is 20 kilometers. This is the question. Now see the next question.
Meters. This is the value of x, but here you need to calculate here
the length at the blade. So what we got x as 87. So we got this value as 87, right? And you need to find the value of the length. If you want to find the value of the length, what is the value of x? We got 87. So if you add 87 plus 26, you will get the length. This is the problem they have given. Again, what they have given, the distance around a rectangular field they have given as 400 meters. That means they have given the perimeter, which is 400, and they have given the condition for the length and the breadth. What they have given, the length is 26 meters more than that of the breadth. Let us consider the breadth as x. Then what will be the length? You have to add 26 meters to that of 1 so that you will get the length. And after calculating the value of x, you got here the value of x is 87, which is the breadth. And if you add 87 to 26, you will get the length. Now try the problem here. What is given here? Given that the perimeter of rectangular field, how much they have given, which is 400 meters, and length is equal to x meters, then the length, what will be the length then according to the question, which is x plus how much meters it is more they have given, 26 meters, x plus 26 meters. Now here according to the problem you can write it here. length of the perimeter of the rectangular field. Here let us consider this is the rectangular field. and they have given the perimeter of the rectangular field is 56 meters. That means they have given the value of 2 into a plus b. They have given how much? 56 meters. And what is the condition given for the length and the width? The length of the rectangular field is 8 meters less than twice of its breadth. That means here, if you don't know what is the breadth here, let us consider it as x. And what they said, the length of the rectangular field is 8 meters less. That means 8 meters less means you need to subtract 8. And what they have said here, less than twice of its breadth. Here the breadth is x. What is the twice? Which is nothing but 2x. So this will be the value of the length. Again, here what they have given here, the length is 8 meters less than twice of its breadth. This is the condition they have given. You don't know what is the breadth. Let us consider it as x. Then what will be the length? Twice means 2x and less than is nothing but minus 8. So here what will be the value of length, which is 2x minus 8? Just you need to substitute the value of length and breadth here. Just substitute here 2 into 2x minus 8 plus x is equal to 56. Now the same thing what we have done it before, just solve it, you will get the x value, and substitute here, you will get the breadth, and substitute here after solving you will get the length. The same thing we have done for the before problem, just they have changed the condition for the length and the breadth. This one you can do it as an homework. Now see the 10th question. Here, in the 10th question, they have given two equal sides of a triangle are 5 meters less than twice the third side. Here, they have given, consider this is the triangle, and they have given that in a triangle two sides are equal. Let us consider these two sides are equal. And what is the condition given here? Two equal sides of a triangle are 5 meters less than twice the third side. Here, let us consider the third side as x. And here what they have given, the other two sides will be twice. Twice means which is nothing but 2 into x. Twice means which is nothing but the double. And what is the condition given here? 5 meters less than twice the third side. Here twice the third side is nothing but 2x, because we took the third side as x. What is the twice the third side which is nothing but 2x? For this 2x, we need to take less than 5. That means you need to subtract this value to 5. So what will be the other side? 2x minus 5. And they have given these two sides are equal. So this side must be equal to 2x minus 5. This is the condition they have given. And what they said again, two sides of a triangle are equal. And we took those two sides are this one. And they have given the condition here, the third side is twice less than 5 the other two sides. That means here we took the third side as twice. What is the price of this one? Which is nothing but 2x. And they have given that value is less than 5. That means you need to subtract minus 5 to this value so that you are getting the other two sides of the triangle. Now you got all the three sides of the triangle based on the question. And what they have given in the question, if the perimeter of the triangle is 55 meters, find the length of its sides. And here they have given the perimeter of the rectangle. What is meant by the perimeter of the rectangle is nothing but the sum of the sides. So here 2x minus 5, this is one side, and 2x minus 5, the other side, and the third side is x. And if you add the sum of the sides, and what they have given, the sum of the sides is equal to 55 meters. Now you need to calculate what are the sides of this triangle. So here you need to calculate first the value of the variable, which is x. And after solving the value of x, if you substitute the value of x in these sides, you will get the remaining sides. So solve it here. 2x plus 2x, which is 4x, plus x, which is 5x. We have added all the variables. So what are the variables here? 2x, 2x and x. 2x plus 2x, which is 4x. 4x plus x, which is 5x. Now add the numbers. Minus 5, minus 5. What is the value of minus 5, minus 5? You know that if two symbols are having the same operations, you need to add the numbers. So what is the value of 5 plus 5, which is 10? So for the bigger number, which symbol is there? Minus 2. So you need to keep it here, minus. 5x minus 10 is equal to 55. Now here, what we are doing here? Subtraction. If you take to the right hand side, what will it become? Addition 55 plus 10. So what you are getting? 5x is equal to 65. Then what is the value of x? 65 by 5. So in 5 table value will be 65, 5 ones are 5. So here 1 will be remaining, 15 will be left out, 5 is a 15. So this is the value. What is the meters they have given? So we got the x value as 30 meters. We got the third side, which is 30 meters. Now you need to calculate the other two sides, which are the equal sides of the triangle. So if you want to calculate, just you need to substitute this x value to here. So what you get? The other sides are 2x minus 5. So 2 into, in place of x substitute here 30 minus 5. You know that 2 into 30, which is nothing but the 26 minus 5. This one you got it as 21 meters. So what are these remaining sides? This one is 21 and this one is 21. Now if you want to check it, you can check it. They said that the perimeter of the rectangle is, perimeter of the triangle is 55. That means if you add 21 plus 21 plus 13, you have to get 55. So you know that 21 plus 21, which is nothing but 42 plus 13, which is 55. So we got the remaining two sides of the triangle. Again, what the question given here? You need to calculate the sides of the triangle, and they have given the perimeter of the triangle is 55, and they have given the condition the third side is twice less than 5 meters of the remaining two sides. So if one side is the other side, it must be 2x minus 5, and after calculating you will get the value of the sides of the triangle. Now write it this one. Let the third side of the triangle is x meters, then the other two sides are 2x minus 5 and 2x minus 5 respectively, and what they have given here, perimeter of the triangle is equal to 55 meters. So what is the perimeter of the triangle, which is nothing but the sum of the sides, is 55 meters. So after this one you can write this one, and after that you can write this one. Right here, for the let the third side be x, then what will be the other two sides? 2x minus 5, and they have given the perimeter. The sum of the sides after calculating you will